If you struggle with erectile dysfunction, I definitely don't need to tell you how frustrating, how overwhelming, and how debilitating the condition can be. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. I work with thousands of men who suffer from sexual arousal dysfunction, something I call SAD, because it is a brain dysfunction that many men mistake for other conditions. So let's dig into the 9 mistakes that most men make when they are trying to overcome and heal erectile dysfunction. So number 1 is that men think that erectile dysfunction is a body problem or a physiological problem with their sexual organ. That is not true for the vast majority of men. I already spoiler alerted you that erectile dysfunction is actually a arousal dysfunction in the brain. What happens is baseline arousal has changed, so then it's difficult to get aroused with a partner. Why does baseline arousal usually change? It's because of porn. So if you've been consuming porn, especially frequently, consistently, and with high levels of intensity, what pornography and other explicit matter does is it desensitizes the dopamine receptors in the reward center in your brain. It changes the reward pathways. And in that desensitization, what happens is now it's difficult to be aroused with a partner because you're no longer getting the very high mental and physical stimulation that comes from porn and masturbation. So we know from science that for most people, erectile dysfunction is brain dysfunction. It is changes in baseline arousal. The second mistake that people make when they're trying to overcome erectile dysfunction is overlooking the psychological factors. So again, I don't need to tell you, if you're suffering from erectile dysfunction, and especially if you haven't shared that with your partner, which many men don't want to, what happens is performance anxiety ramps up. Having SAD or sexual arousal dysfunction is very stressful and anxiety provoking. So what most people don't understand is that psychological factors are actually neurological factors. Let me say it again. Psychological factors are actually brain neurological factors. Most people don't understand that anxiety is brain-based. So the way that it works is if you're struggling with anything that makes you anxious, it ramps up the energy in your brain and it speeds it up so that now your baseline operating mode of electrical energy in your brain is faster than healthy baseline. That's one of the components that goes along with porn, which I call strained brain, but it also happens due to performance anxiety when erectile dysfunction is in the mix. So the psychological stress and anxiety makes it so that your brain is running faster than it should due to the fact that you're struggling with erectile dysfunction. Number 3, the third mistake that people make when they're trying to overcome erectile dysfunction is dismissing their lifestyle or habits, dismissing the role that the way that you live your life can impact your brain and hence can impact your ability to get an erection and to be able to orgasm with a partner. Now, again, I already spoiled this for you that when your baseline arousal changes, now it's difficult to be with a human being who on a good day is likely a 7, 8, or 9 on the 1 to 10 scale of arousal. That's the healthy arousal scale that exists in the real world. Pornography exists up at 15. We know that it is a super normal stimulus. It increases the level of dopamine in your brain to super normal unhealthy levels that lead to the desensitization. So many people do not take into account that the way you live your life matters when it comes to sexual arousal dysfunction, namely pornography and explicit matter consumption. Number four on our scale of mistakes that people make when they're trying to overcome erectile dysfunction is neglecting your overall well-being through healthy self-care. Now, to me, as a cognitive neuroscientist, that includes balancing the way you use your brain across the day and across your life. It also means getting a great night's sleep so that your brain can restore itself and become refreshed for the next day. When you balance the way you use your brain, what it does is it brings your brain into the green zone, optimal brain performance pattern. I call it the green zone because on the QEEG brain map assessment, which is the type of assessment that I offer, it is a neuroscience assessment that shows you how your brain is performing. On that assessment, a healthy brain pattern is all green. For people who have consumed pornography and who struggle with sexual arousal dysfunction, there's a lot of red. It's a brain on fire. Strained brain leads to drained brain. Drained brain is at the root of erectile dysfunction. And the way you live your life and how you take your well-being and balancing your brain across the day can really impact those brain patterns. The fifth mistake that people make when they're overcoming erectile dysfunction is thinking that it's age-related. Now, we know from science, and the science is stacking up, that in 2024, there are so many young men struggling with sexual arousal dysfunction due to porn use. Now more than ever, erectile dysfunction has shifted to younger men and middle and older gentlemen, but it's not age-related like it was a very long time ago when high-speed internet pornography was not in the mix. And we already covered it. It's because the supernormal stimulus of pornography and explicit matter is desensitizing the brain, leading to difficulty being sensitized in a healthy sexual experience. So we know that it's not age-related. It very much is related to porn-induced erectile dysfunction. Number six is overlooking the relationship between porn consumption and erectile dysfunction. So there is a direct relationship. So what happens with the people that I work with is when they decide to give up pornography, then slowly but surely their brain heals and their sexual arousal dysfunction, their SAD, goes away. So sometimes this happens automatically, which I call the unwire phase. So you stop watching porn, you stop masturbating. Yes, I said that. And what happens is your brain starts slowly but surely moving back towards the green zone optimal brain pattern. But sometimes people's brains don't make it all the way there by itself. That's why I use state-of-the-art advanced technology to shift your brain back to the green zone. And catch this, your brain may have never been in the green zone if you found porn and masturbation when you were young. Brains develop all the way until the age of 28 in men. So if you found porn, and especially if you were using porn frequently, consistently, and with any level of intensity, your brain has likely never developed to that green zone brain pattern. But it's still there for the taking. We know through the beauty of neuroplasticity that when you leave porn behind, what happens is your brain will start to unwire. And if you need help, I can help you rewire your brain in the right direction using technology so you can feel and perform maybe better than ever. Okay, so the seventh mistake that people make when they are overcoming erectile dysfunction is to discount emotional issues that might be happening in their life. Now, I know that I tend to do this, even with sexual arousal dysfunction not being in the mix. Many of us do. Emotional problems or situations that arise in our life can impact us. And especially if you've been caught in the loop of pornography, you're likely used to avoiding and escaping difficult feelings. But those difficult feelings or those challenging emotional situations in your life, they take a toll on your brain. And like I've already shared with you, it could lead to strained brain, too much anxiety, too much fatigue and overwhelm. And if your brain is already in that mode because of SAD, then what happens is it will make it even worse. All of these mistakes work together. So if you have emotional situations going on, it's time to address them. It's time to approach and engage so your brain can move towards that green zone. The eighth mistake that people make when they're trying to heal ED is overlooking or possibly perhaps not even being aware of dopamine dysregulation. So ED, delayed ejaculation, and SAD are all challenges that happen in the brain because of a dopamine dysregulation. So if porn is in the mix, a dopamine dependency is likely at the core. Your brain is used to going to high levels of dopamine to feel good, and ultimately at some point to not feel bad. So what happens is now there's a dysregulated use and need for dopamine to offset the stress of life. At the same time, a porn habit increases stress in your life because we know if you have a dopamine dependency, it leads to a dopamine deficit when you're in your actual life. And the ninth example is overlooking the connection of the central nervous system to the peripheral nervous system, and essentially overlooking the connection between brain, mind, body, and the ability to have an erection and to have a nice, pleasurable, connected sexual experience with a partner. If you've taught your brain to go into the screen, it's used to getting very high levels of dopamine to become aroused. That is in the central nervous system, which sends the signals to the peripheral nervous system, which sends those nerve impulses from your brain to your body, telling you to become aroused. But your signals are crossed and you need very high levels of stimulation. So this connection between the nervous systems, it can be healed starting with a top-down approach, meaning when we regulate your brain, your body will work better too. If you're looking for help on this journey to heal sexual arousal dysfunction, I would love to help you. Please go over to drtrishleigh.com and check out the page on erectile dysfunction. There's two primary programs that I offer. One is a digital program. One is the assessment so we can see what is happening in your brain. If you're not ready for one of those comprehensive programs, join Brain Training 101. It's an entry-level brain training community where I can show you how to use the brain training headband and how to train your brain with your mind and body. There's a special discussion group in that program for sexual arousal dysfunction. So I at least hope to see you there. All right, until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.